From App One to LimbPossible, these young men continue to motivate, inspire, and win over audiences around the country, proving that you can do it, you just have to put your mind to it. From basketball to hockey, LimbPossible has demonstrated a level of enthusiasm that is quite infectious. From LimbPossible, let's welcome Robert Rodriquez.
How's it going, Mike?
Good. Also, Jovan Booker.
Hi.
Welcome back, and Patrick Filosa.
Nice to be here.
Good to see you guys again.
You too.
Last time we were together, we were at the Stuy Dome.
We were throwing balls,
we were throwing passes, shooting hoops, and having a little fun.
A little bit of everything, right?
How's it been going so far? And what's also, you are still part of AMP One, but you also created your own organization called LimbPossible. Why?
We had to create LimbPossible because we were kind of making a lot of noise in New York, and we wanted to make a platform available for everyone, not just basketball, available for other sports, for women, and not only amputees. We help kids with Down syndrome, autism, and hemophilia as well.
Okay, you guys are involved in the level of sports. I know you're in hockey right now.
Yes, sled hockey. It's been a lot of fun. We've started playing in it since January. Been able to travel a little bit with the team, so I've been blessed. We play for the New York Rangers and the Long Island Rough Riders.
Yeah. In June, I'm going to train with the U.S. National Amputee Soccer Team. So I'll be with them in June, and I'll also be with them in July for the Copa. So that's a new venture for me. I played soccer for first about 14 years of my life, so it's a nice transition from basketball back into something I love as well.
Cool. From now, AMP One was basically basketball, right? Was it?
Yes.
And LimbPossible has opened up. You guys are now limitless in terms of sports.
Exactly. That's it. Anything is possible. That's our motto.
LimbPossible.
Anything is possible.
So what's your favorite sport right now? You guys are just trying everything, or?
Well, mine personally has been, so I've recently just be appearing on NBC's American Ninja Warrior, season 9. So ninja training is actually something new that I actually love, because I've always kind of felt like I've had ability to be that kind of athlete. So it's a lot of upper body strength.
Now, were there other amputees with?
There was actually one other amputee on the show with me.
Yeah. How did you get approached about that?
I just said, hey, man, I'm missing a leg, too. What about the show?
Yeah.
So the show I submitted, actually. I didn't think I was going to get on the show. They didn't give me a call until about mid-April, actually the day after my birthday. And so I got the call to be on the show, but I submitted back in December. So luckily enough, they liked my story and my athletic ability.
What brought on LimbPossible? Was it a conversation I remember during when we were shooting a story that we just previously aired? You were discussing, I know you were discussing with Eric Hicks, about the possibility of creating your own organization. We were at the Stuy Dome and we were just sitting around talking, especially after the package, after the story. And Eric Hicks said, hey, you know, you guys should possibly maybe go on your own and do your own thing.
Yeah, he was definitely a big part of
that. Was monumental for us. That was monumental for us. I think we all walked away from that kind of with a different perception of everything. And our biggest need and what we wanted to do was just do this all the time and to do it as often as possible. And through different opportunities, we found ourselves the ones that were actually putting a lot of work into it and putting a lot of effort. So we took it upon ourselves to step away and do something different.
Patrick, when did this come about? When is it October? Was
January.
It after January?
So okay. About January, we started LimbPossible, and it's grown a lot ever since. So we've been really blessed to do this.
And I guess now folks, when they see amputees now, they look at them basically as limitless, especially when it comes to movement, thinking. I mean, it's not a problem at all.
Exactly.
I mean, especially now when I see people walking down the street, I saw they probably run faster than me.
Exactly, yeah.
You know what it is? It's all about, you know, being down, being depressed isn't going to bring our legs back. So you can't be that way. You got to have a positive mental attitude and just always think positive, because like I said, it's us being down and depressed isn't going to bring it back. So
your condition, especially, you were born with it. Explain.
So I was born with neurofibromatosis. It's a very rare disease, affects about 1,000 to 3,000 people. So my left leg was shorter, weaker than the other one. I had a lot of different surgeries to try to fix it. Nothing really worked for me. So about 4 years ago, I just decided it would be better for me just to have the leg amputated. And it's been the best thing that ever happened to me. I've met these two guys. They've took me under my wing. They've been my best friends. And I'm a testament of what LimbPossible is all about.
All three of you were always involved in sports?
Yeah.
Grew up playing sports my entire life, never thinking that I would be able to make a team or have the impact that we're having now, not feeling good enough. They say, you know, one in a million become a basketball player, you know, but With AMP 1 and LimbPossible, we've been able to travel across the country, play NBA halftimes, meet celebrities, so we feel like we're professionals.
And something that we all speak about at schools, and even he just mentioned, is confidence, something that we never had growing up. We walked around in the summer with pants on. We were ashamed kind of our amputations. And now with the opportunities and the ability, us kind of stepping out of our comfort zone, taking a leap, as we always say, it's given us a newfound confidence, and we want to instill that into others and pay it forward.
And as you grew into adults, into teenagers, you had to adjust your prosthetic, right?
Big time.
Would you take off your prosthetic part?
Sure. So all of our prosthetic legs are custom. The socket is custom to my residual limb. So my stump actually just goes right into it. So I can't wear Jovan's leg or Patrick's, and they can't wear mine. And every year, it's not too heavy.
Okay.
Carbon fiber.
Yeah, great material, the strongest material for us. Mm-hmm. A lot of amputees, and especially new amputees, might get it covered to look like their other leg where the skin and the mold,
you know. You didn't want to do that.
We used to do that when we were younger.
Yeah, we did.
But now we're comfortable, and we used to have to get a new leg about every year growing up.
Huh, okay. And
excuse his Mets leg.
No problem.
As
I know he's a Mets fan.
We're Yankees fans. We don't want to break any cameras out here.
The pin lock's not working right now.
So. Okay, no problem. But as far as the technology, how has the technology also improved your prosthesis?
So for Jovan and myself, we grew up this way. So we've had prosthetics since the 90s, where there's indentation on the feet now. The toes are split, so you can wear like flip-flop sandals. Back then, they didn't have that. A lot of the feet were carbon fiber. Now they have fiberglass feet. If you're an above-the-knee amputee, there's microprocessors and mechanical knees that allow you to walk different. Same thing for upper extremity amputees. Myoelectric arms allow them to move their fingers and attach it to their nerves. So the technology from 25 years ago is night and day, and it's actually given us a way better quality of life and allows us to play sports.
What's in the future? What's happening right now? As far as I know, you got a lot of different things, projects you're working on.
Sure. Coming up, so in 2018, we're actually working on our first trip to Africa, working with the Peace Corps. So that's something big that we have coming up. We're going to be in the Amputee Coalition Conference in Kentucky. And like Jovan said, him and I are going to try out for the U.S. National Amputee Soccer Team. And then American Ninja Warrior will be airing. And we have schools booked until December of the end of this year. So that's our focus of building LimbPossible.
What about also the Olympics? Is the Olympics a possibility?
The Paralympics, in 2020.
Right?
It's a big focus for us. That's kind of what we've been building up towards. I mean, a lot of us have been involved in a lot of different things, but we do take pride in just being athletes for any sport. And we want the opportunity to represent our country, not only for one sport, but for a bunch of different things. I'm going for high jump, sprints, and he's doing various other things as well.
Triathlon.
Yeah.
What has been also the reaction of children overall when you go to schools, when you speak before them in their classrooms, in the gyms, that sort of thing?
All three of us grew up handicapped in a sense. So when we go to schools, that's kind of our bread and butter. That's where we get our motivation from. That reminds us why we do this every day.
What do you think of those words, handicapped, physically challenged?
I'm okay with them now, because I know that they're just words.
Right. Yeah.
But we know that we have abilities instead of disabilities.
How do you feel about that, Austin?
Same thing is, you just can't let nothing stop you. You just gotta keep pushing forward and do anything you want, and anything's possible.
LimbPossible. What's that right here?
This is for you, sir.
Shirt
and a wristband.
We come with gifts.
We're right here.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you.
And
we got wristbands?
Yes, sir.
Yep. Oh, great. Okay, I have to give these out. Thanks for coming.
Thanks for having us.
Right. Thank you. All right, good. Good to see you guys again.